Hello everyone, thank you for joining today's webinar. I'm Kavita Gopalan from Samsung Developer Program team. We are based out of Mountain View, California. And some of the housekeeping items for today's webinar is all attendees will automatically be muted during the webinar to limit disruption. If you have any questions, please post them in the chat box in the Q&A box. We will reply at the end of the session. If you have any technical issues during the webinar, please send a chat to the Samsung host for assistance. So this session is being recorded and will be shared with the presentation slides on Samsung Developer website. And please don't forget to respond to survey posted on the end of the webinar. So as I mentioned, we are part of Samsung Developer Program team. We offer a lot of services and there are a lot of benefits if you join our Samsung Developer Program team. We provide a monthly newsletter with all the information you need from a developer or designer perspective. You will get to know a lot of information about the events and the SDKs that's being released by Samsung. So we highly encourage you to become a member of our Samsung Developer Program. And we also provide technical support for Samsung Android SDKs, and we also support tools like Team Editor tool and Galaxy Watch Designer tool. So if you have, you are working on any of these SDKs and any of the tools and you need assistance or have questions, you can submit a technical support request and we will reply back to you within 24 hours. And we also have a developer discount program where we offer the devices at a discounted rate for Samsung Developer Program members. The percentage of the discount and the device availability varies from time to time, so we suggest keep looking at, have an eye on it, so to see what is the current discount. And you can also submit a promotion request. If you submit a promotion request, we will highlight your application with a banner in the main page of the Galaxy App Store. So this increases 4 times the downloads of the application. So if you think you need visibility for your application, please submit a promotion request. And we also have a Galaxy Apps badge generator. Using this badge, you can promote your application in your own channels or social media channels, so which will again increase your downloads. So if you want to get a Galaxy badge for your application, please come to our website and submit a request there. And you'll also be able to see all the information regarding our upcoming events, what events we have done in the past, etc. And we are offering a new service called Cloud Device Swarm, using which you'll be able to test your Android application on a real device remotely. So these are some of the benefits if you join our Samsung Developer Program. We have done a lot of webinars very similar to the one we are doing right now. Focusing on all different aspects of app development, starting from product overview to how to design a watch face for the Samsung watch, how to develop watch face, how to develop watch application, how to publish it, promote it, how to get, how to monetize your application, etc. So please go to the webinar page. You'll be able to see a lot of webinars which is very useful to you. And now, let's deep dive into our product that we are focusing today, our new Samsung Galaxy Watch. The market situation right now, as everybody knows, the market for the smartwatch has increased 60% because everybody has been using the fitness band, has been moving up, to, up, and they are trying to buy the smartwatch. So the, if you want to develop a watch face using a tool, there is a wide range of market available for your application. And when we look at the demographics, we are seeing there is a switch, slight increase in the female demographics when compared to male. Previously, it has been male, male audience and users. But now that we have the new watch in two different sizes, we can see that there's going to be more female users who are going to buy our rose gold version of the watch as well. So when you want to design an application or a watch face, that's something you might have to keep in mind. And we also see that there is a continuous increase in LTE-enabled smartwatch sales. So previously, the only Bluetooth version of the watch was sold, but now we see that there is an increase in number of people who like to use LTE-enabled smartwatch as well. That means you can come up with a watch face or an application that can run in a standalone mode, which does not, there is no dependency on the mobile phone at all for your application. And we also see that the ASPs have been shifting to more premium devices that are starting from $300 or more. So people are ready to buy a smartwatch even for $300 or more. That is the information we got through the surveys. And Galaxy Watch specifications. So this is the newest watch in the market right now, and we have bumped up the battery. It lasts up to 7 days, and there is a rotating bezel. The display is round, and it is compatible with Samsung Pay and SmartThings. And durability is 5 ATM. And we have a lot of other useful apps like Spotify, which provides offline music, and there are many sensors, heart rate monitor, GPS, sleep sensor, stress tracking, and many applications that are compatible with the devices used in the gym. So you can create your, these are some of the information that might be useful if you want to create a fitness-based watch face. And we have a lot of fitness apps like Under Armour, Samsung Health, and this watch also supports always-on realistic watch face. And there is a lot of options for personalization, like users can change the straps, watch face, and it comes in 2 different sizes and 3 different colors. Now, let's focus on what are the things that you need to keep in mind when you design a watch face. So for those who are totally new to Samsung Watch and we have never seen it before, I want to give a high-level overview of how the watch works. As you can see, the main home screen is where your watch face resides. So that is the watch face app that you will be creating using the Galaxy Watch Designer tool. So it has a very high visibility, and when the user rotates the bezel to the right side of the watch face, they can see a lot of widgets that is available on the watch. And when they rotate the bezel to the left side of the watch face, that's where all the notifications reside. If the watch is paired with the phone, all the notification that comes to the mobile will automatically be relayed to the watch, unless the user has specifically turned off that particular feature in the phone. There are 2 buttons in the watch, the back button and the home button. Back button obviously takes the user to the previous screen. And the home button, when they click on the home button, it opens the app tray. That's where all the applications are installed. And it is also the power button. When it's long pressed, you can turn on or turn off the watch. And where do users download the watch face application that you publish? So users will be downloading it from the Galaxy App Store, the Samsung's own App Store, very similar to Google Play and Apple Store. So this is how it looks. Have some screenshots available. So the first screenshot shows the banners. That's where if your promotion request has been accepted, you will have your own banner there as well. So you can imagine the high visibility your app will get when you have a banner running on our store. And the second screenshot shows the app detail page. That is very important. It attracts the users and gives first impression of how your watch face looks. So we suggest you to give high priority to use very detailed images of your watch face application. So users will get attracted and know how your watch face works and they start downloading your app. So designing for the watch face. As I have mentioned, it is a circular display. So please design your watch face for the circle. So watch face can be like a traditional watch face, can be analog, or it can be digital, or you can create your own custom watch face, which does not fall under both of these categories, either analog or digital. So you can get inspiration from the classic wristwatch, or you can get your inspiration from other real life scenarios. So some things that to keep in mind when you design your watch face is to make it fashionable, because most of the users who use the watch face use it as a fashion accessory. So 80% of users care for the design. Make it always beautiful whether the screen is on or not. So we suggest you to create both active state as well as always on state. So if you don't create your own always on state, there is a default always on watch face that will be displayed. but we highly suggest you to create your own always-on state as well. Be clear in your aim. So first, think and come up with your aim, what your watch face, what you want to offer to the users through your watch face. If you want to focus on fitness, then try to use some fitness complications like a floor or a step count or whatever you think, and show that information in a relevant style. Watch face should be tailored to a particular situation or a need, as users can choose from a wide range of watch faces. So as you know, there are many watch faces available, so think of how your watch face can be different from other watch faces. Try to keep watch face design simple and elegant, and use or take advantage of all the complications and sensors that is available on the device. People want something new. Something new doesn't mean that you have to come up with totally different functionality. It's just that they like to see it in a new look and feel. The best-selling watch faces are ever-changing, like fashion. So 60% of users download new watch face every month, and 22% download new watch face every week. 49% of users have more than 20 watch faces. So watch face with good design attracts users to download, attract 80% of the users, and with rich information attracts 72% of the users. So keep it classic or show tons of information. You can choose how you want your watch face to be, and always design for the always on state as well. What is the core value of the watch face? So obviously the watch face should show time. Instead of just showing the time, you can also add more functionality and provide more information to the users. So you can use a complication, and to make a utility complication, or make your watch face fitness kind of whichever. So try to add more functionality to your watch face instead of just showing the time. So let's see how what are the things that you need to focus on visual design. These are some of the examples of preloaded watch face that is available in our latest device. Designed with the craftsmanship mind, so users enjoy illustrations, motions, and most importantly, the originality of the watch face. Some things to focus on is the font design you want to use, and it has to be a full-fledged design. You can think of depth expression, light source effect, or other use cases of a watch face that can be based on the functionality. What is the watch face design process? So first think of the project and come up with a goal. Then think about the visual category. What are the visual elements that you would like to add to the watch face? And design the visual visual effects with your own design tool. Whichever tool you are familiar with, it can be a Photoshop or Illustrator, whatever you use, and then come to the Galaxy Watch Designer tool and start developing the watch face. And add advanced design functionality that we have provided in the Galaxy Watch Designer tool. These are some of the examples of how you can get some of the inspirations that you can use to create a realistic design for your watch face. So it can be a realistic watch plus true material and depth. Elaborate and give detailed information of the design you want to use. Realistic watch face plus a digital cue, modern and sleek, and you can come up with your own designer signature look, which would attract young and casual people. So these are some of the things that you can get inspired from the real world. You can come up with a dynamic, bold, professional complexity, or you can focus on enhanced, realistic, and you can use reflection depending on the texture, or you can design a sleek watch face with splash of color, fashion stream, and cool finishing. These are some design aspects that you can get inspired to create a realistic watch face. So some of the design tips, keep the circular display in mind. So like a list view or a grid may not work that well. And your watch face should be glanceable. So all the users will be looking at the watch face only for a minimum amount of time. So in that minimum amount of time, you should be able to convey your message to the users. So always keep that in mind, and your watch face should be glanceable. Think about the visibility, and it has, if you are using any text, it should be readable. And focus on the essential qualities, the hands-on design and live watch. And you can add more quality to your watch face by adding a motion element or giving more detail to a specific element in your watch face. So you can design a prototype to emphasize your personality. Understanding the circular grid makes it more effective and better design. We always suggest to consider the rotating bezel. That will let you add use the screen more efficiently. Emphasize the elements that attract the eyes. In this example, as you can see, the watch hand is the one that attracts the eyes. So they have emphasized the design and the color for that particular element. And the last one, the heart, is used as a hover hand, so that attracts the eyes as well. So that has been emphasized in that particular watch face. So these are some of the examples. While designing always on display, always keep the background subtle, because when you're using always on display, the display will always be on, so it should not drain too much battery power. So please keep that in mind when you design for the always on mode. The visual, test the visual in real world and increase the details. So first, you can come up with the first version of your watch face and try install it on a real device and try it. And when you start using it, you might come up with more ways to refine your watch face application, and you can add more detail. So upgrade your watch face with sensible and meaningful motion. So like this example shows pumping heart, or you can come up with some more cues that would attract users. So as you might have already known, Samsung has been pioneer with us in releasing the Samsung's watches. We have been releasing watches starting from 2013. So every year we have been releasing a new smartwatch series which has improved over a period of time. So our latest version is the Galaxy Watch, and the watches that I have highlighted in blue are the ones that are supported by the Galaxy Watch Designer tool. So you'll be able to create a watch face either for Gear S, that is rectangular display, or all the circular series like Gear S 2, Gear S 3, Gear Sport and Classic Watch. And the Galaxy Watch Designer tool also supports fitness band like Gear Fit 2 and Gear Fit 2 Pro. So you'll be able to create watch face even for those fitness bands. Okay, so now that we have seen the design guideline and the tips, let's deep dive into the Galaxy Watch Designer tool and what some of the new features that is available in the latest version. Galaxy Watch Designer is a simple one-stop shop for visual designers who are looking to produce and distribute their own watch faces. You can create your own designs in your own design tool and bring them onto Galaxy Watch Designer tool, compile it into a watch face, and you can use all the additional functionality that the tool offers, compile the watch face, and then publish it in the Galaxy App Store. So some of the new features that is available in the latest version of our tool are tag expressions and runtime permission. Tag expressions lets the designers use their own script to add more functionality and more features for a particular element in your watch face. And runtime permission, there has been an update in the Tizen 4.0 platform. That is the Tizen platform where the Galaxy Watch is running on right now. By law, it is required that the developer has to let the users know how the watch face is using users' personal data. It can be either heart rate or it can be a step count, whatever, everything is considered as user's personal data. So we should let them know how it is being used. So when your watch face is being installed on Tizen 4.0, it shows a pop-up asking the user, prompting the user saying that this watch face uses this sensor, etc. So user will be able to either accept or decline that particular information. So that is one of the changes that has been brought up in Tizen 4.0. And so Galaxy Watch Designer tool allows you to create two different binaries, one for targeting 4.0 and above, and the other one for 3.0 and below. So right now, Gear S3 and below are running with Tizen 3.0 platform, and Galaxy Watch is running in 4.0 platform. So that is the reason why you have to create two different binaries if you want to support all the Samsung watch available in the market. So now let's deep dive into the tag expression. So tag expression lets developers and the designers to add their own script to dynamically change the component properties, which was not available before. So you may not have been able to change the properties dynamically during the runtime, but this tag expression lets you add your own property to a particular element. So each element in the tool has a tag value that has been predefined. For example, if it's a step percentage, the tag is ST, and for a hover hand, it is H. So for all the elements that is available in the tool, there is a predefined tag. So using this predefined tag, you will be able to add your own mathematical expressions to either move the placement of that object, or rotate the angle or whatever in the tool. So that gives you more flexibility to add more interesting feature in the watch face. So tag expression supports arithmetic operations like plus, minus, multiplication, division, and remainder. And it also supports relational operators that we have mentioned here. And it also supports a ternary operator. So it gives you a wide range of flexibility and functionality. Two things to keep in mind while using the tag expression are the values within the parameter will be evaluated first, and expression equal to returns 1 if the condition is true. If the condition is false, it returns 0. So it, if you are already familiar with programming, it is very simple and very easy to understand. And even if you are new to programming, we have a lot of predefined templates and examples available in the latest tool, which you can try it on your own and get familiar with. It is very simple. Now, let's deep dive into a simple example. We have a simple example here that I want to show you in this webinar. So when we explain about the sample, you will know how simple it is to create a tag expression. In this particular sample, we are using three different elements. We are using a digital clock, and we are going to use the tag expression to rotate the angle of the digital clock. We are also using another digital clock, which you see three vertical bars here, and we are going to move the placement of these three vertical bars using tag expression. And we are also going to use step percentage element, and the image below, we are going to use three different objects for the step percentage, and we are going to change the opacity, and we are also going to change the placement of those objects using tag expression. So let's see how this works. So when you open the Galaxy Watch Designer tool, so the one highlighted now is a digital clock, and it has been formatted to the right side. And using the tag expression, we are going to change the angle. So we can change it during the runtime. So as you can see, there is a triangle on the properties, rotate the window. When I click that, it opens the script window, and I have written this expression to rotate. I am changing the value of the seconds based on that calculation. So let's see how it runs, how it works when I run the sample. As you can see, the digital clock 1 keeps on updating and changing the angle for every second. So you can come up with your own calculation and use that calculation in the script window, and you'll be able to change the property of that element dynamically. So just that simple, to change the rotation property of that particular digital clock. So now let's move on to the tag expression that we are going to use for the second digital clock component, which is nothing but we have three different bars, one for hour hand, one for minute hand, and one for the second hand. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move this vertical bar from bottom to top depending upon the second value of the second, value of the minute, or value of the hour. So the total height of this bar that I'm using is 180 pixels by 180 pixels. So the reference point is at the the reference point is 180 by 180. So in order to move this particular bar from bottom to top, I need to move it along the x-axis. Since I'm moving it from bottom to top, I need to change the negative value of the y-axis. So that's how it's going to move from bottom to top. If I want to move it along horizontally, then I have to change the x-axis value. So this is how we came up with this calculation for the placement. So each bar is 150 pixel in height. So we need to move each bar from bottom to top. For the hover hand, I want to show the entire 150 pixel of the entire bar when the time is 24 hour. So that means I have to show 6.25 pixels for every hour. Similar way for the minute hand, if it is 60 minutes, I want to show the entire 150 pixel. So for 1 minute, I have to show 2.5 pixels. Same way for the seconds. For the 60 second, I have to show the entire 150 pixel bar. That means that I have to move the seconds hand 2.5 pixels per second. So let's see how to implement that functionality in the Galaxy Watch Designer tool. As you can see, there are three images, the vertical bars that we are using, that is the second hand, the green bar that we are using, and yellow is the minute hand, and blue is the hour hand. So we'll be moving this vertical bar from bottom to top. When we go to the properties window, select the placement property and click on the triangle that is on the left side of the text box, that will open the script window. So I'm entering this calculation that I explained just before for the hover hand. So I'm moving negative hover times 6.25. So I want to move hover times 6.25 pixels for every hover. Same way for the minute hand, I'm going to change the property of the placement for the y-axis. I'm not changing it for the x-axis because I'm not moving it horizontally. I'm moving it vertically. So I'm changing the y-axis. So that would be minus m times 2.5. M is the tag for minute hand. So I'm changing the property of the, changing the placement property for this particular object. Same way, I'm changing the second hand. Select the y-axis property for this particular element and input the expression in the script window. So minus second times 2.5 pixels, that's how much I want to move this bar for every second. So now we are done inputting the tag expression for these three hands. Let's run and see how that works. Click the run window, that will open the emulator. As you can see, the second bar keeps moving 2.5 pixels from bottom to top for every second. The minute hand moves 6.25 pixels every minute. Same way, hover hand moves for every hover from bottom to top on the negative y-axis. So it is so simple to use the tag expressions. You can come up with your own calculation and your imagination is the limit to what you can do to set the property of the element that you'll be using for your watch face. Now let's take a look at the pedometer complication that we are using. So for this, we are having three different objects, object 1, object 2, and object 3. Object 1 is in a standing position, so that we want to show this object once when the step count is 0. When the step count is between 1 and 99, I want to show object 2. And when step count is equal to 100, I want to show object 3. So now let's see how we can implement that using the tag expression. So object 1 or object A appears when step count is 0. So the tag expression will be, as I mentioned earlier, the expression inside the parenthesis will be executed first. So step count equal to 0 is true. So if it is true, it will return 1. So that means the opacity 100 times 1 is 100. Opacity will be 100 for object A. For object B, when the step count is between 1 and 99, object A will disappear and object B will appear. And I'm going to move the placement for this particular object B. When step count equal to 100, object B will disappear and I'm going to show object C. So I'm going to change two different properties for these objects, opacity and placement. Let's see how that works. So when you look at the timeline, so these are the three images that I'm using for the objects. So pedo run image, pedo finish image, and pedo normal image. So these are the three objects that I'm using for the pedometer. And when you go to the properties window and choose the appearance, that's where you can change the opacity for that particular image. So click on the script window, and for normal object, when the step count is equal to 0, I want to show the first image. So that is the expression that I have entered inside the script window. And for the second one, the pedo run image, go to the properties window and change the placement, because I want to move this image from left to right every time there is an increase in the step count. And I want to keep the opacity 100 if the value is between 1 and 99. So if ST is greater than or equal to 1 and ST is less than or equal to 99, opacity should be 100. That is the expression I am entering in the script window. And go to the placement. I am going to change the X value because I want this object to move horizontally, not vertically. So select the script window for the x-axis value placement parameter and enter the expression there. So if the ST is less than or equal to 99, true, then I will move it that particular pixels. So if it is 1, the object will move 1 pixel to the right. And for the last image, this I want this to be visible only when step count equal to 100. So I'm going to just change the opacity property. Click on the script window for that property and change. If ST is greater than or equal to 100, opacity should be 100. That's when this particular object will be visible. Rest of the times, the opacity will be 0, so it will not be visible. So this is how simple it is to change the property and the opacity. And let's see how it works. Let's go and try to emulate the percentage step percentage value in the emulator. As you can see, when the step count is greater than 1 and less than 99, I'm showing object 2. When the step count is equal to 100, I'm showing object 3. When the step count was 0, I was showing object 1. Voila! So we have had, we have implemented the tag expression for this pedometer complication. So that's how simple it is to implement it. And let's move on to the next complication. Here we are also changing the background. For in the sample, we are also changing the background depending upon the battery percentage. This is a simple hide and show property in the timeline. We are not using tag expression for this because we just want to change the background image for a particular value. So as you can see, there are three different background images I'm using for the battery complication. And if the value of the battery is between 0 and 15, I'm using one image. And if it's between 15 and 80, second image. And if it is greater than 80, I'm going to use third image. The brightness of the background will increase or decrease depending upon the value of the battery. So let's try and run it in the window, run window to see how it works. If the battery is zero, it's dark. If the battery is between 15 and 80, it will be bright. And if the battery is greater than 80, it's going to be even brighter. So this is just another simple feature that we have used for this particular sample app. Okay, so now we have seen how to implement tag expressions. And in this particular sample, we have focused on changing the tag expressions for opacity and changing the placement value. It is so simple. So I hope this would have given a high level overview, and it would help you to get started using the tag expression in your own watch face. So if you have any questions, please feel free to create a ticket and we'll here to help you on that. Moving on to the next new feature that is available in this tool, it is the runtime permission. As I explained earlier, from Tizen 4.0, there has been a change that it is necessary for the app to get permission from the user to access his personal data, like the sensor data. So because of this, there has been a change in the platform level. So we have to create two different binaries for 4.0 and 4.0 and above, and for 3.0 and below. So our tool makes it easy for you to create two different binaries. So you can compile in the build window, you'll be able to see options to build it for two different API levels. And it automatically adds a suffix TW3 or TW4 depending upon what platform level you're building your TPK with. Couple of things to keep in mind when you are creating two different binaries is the package name should be same for both the binaries, but the version level should be different. So if you create a 3.0, the version level can be 1, and if you are creating for 4.0, it can be 1.0.1, and the target level for the two binaries should be different. So let me show you how this actually can be done in the real tool. So in the Galaxy Watch Designer tool, you can go to Project and click on Build option. There you'll be able to see an option called Target API Version. So there are two options to select from that. So what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to build a binary for 3.0 and below. So I'm going to the option, select the drop down and select 3.0 and version below version. Enter your author certificate password. I'm keeping the version as 1.0.0 and then building the application. And there is an image for preview that you can provide in this particular tool. So now we have built the binary for 3.0 and below. Now I'm going to do the same process to build a binary for 4.0 platform level and above. So go to Project, click Build option. I'm changing the version number because it's not going to let you update both the binaries in Seller Office if the version number is the same. So I'm changing the version number, selecting 4.0 API level. You can upload your preview image if you want. Otherwise, system will use the same default preview image. And I'm building the binary. So now we are done creating two different binaries for two different platform levels. So the preview image is the image that will appear when the user long presses the watch face and tries to switch to a different watch face. So until now, it was showing our default platform image that was available in the watch. But if you want to have your own image, you can provide the image here in the build window that I was talking about. So after building the two different binaries, as you can see, it automatically adds the suffix TW3 and TW4 TPK in the location in your own workspace. So That's how you create two different binaries for two different platform levels. We have seen some issues, we are experiencing some issues with the IAP feature in this tool. We will reply back to you soon. I know many of you have created a ticket. We will reply back to that very soon when we receive an official reply from our developer team, and we'll post that information in the forum as well. So that's about it. This brings to the end of our webinar. I think some of you have all asked some questions. Let's go to questions. Any plans to update S3 support fit to Tizen 4.0? Right now, there are no plans for fit 2 to update to Tizen 4.0, but Gear S3 and I think Gear Sport will also receive an update pretty soon, maybe in a couple of months or so. I don't have the exact date, but yeah, those devices will get an update. Next question, will the prompt about using personal data be generated automatically, or has the watch face author to make them? No, that prompt will appear automatically for all the apps and all the watch faces that a user tries to install on the 4.0 platform and about devices. So that change has been made in the platform level, so we don't have handle to change it. That automatically appears depending on what kind of sensor data you use. If you use a heart rate, it's going to prompt that information to the user. If you're using a step count, the kind of information comes in the pop-up changes according to the sensor you use. Does GWD support nested conditions in one expression? Nested conditions. I need to check about that. If you could create an email or a ticket, we can talk about this later. Like, I think you mean like if condition or something like that. So I need more information of exactly what you're asking about, so I can follow up on that through the ticket. Let the image. Moving on to the next question. As a tap action activator, if I let the image which has a tap action activated to move around the screen using expressions, will the touch sensitive area also wander according to the visual movement? No, I think this is only for the predefined. That's a good question. I haven't tried that. I can try follow up. Please create a ticket and I will follow up on that and reply back to you. Okay, so that's about the questions we have. If you have any more questions, please feel free to create a ticket and I can reply back to you through email and tickets. Okay, so we have Samsung Developer Conference coming up pretty soon. It's November 7th and 8th in Moscone Center in San Francisco. Please register it. And yeah, I think it will be a great event for all the designers and developers who are using our Samsung SDKs and tools. You can meet all of us in person there. So we highly recommend you to register today and participate in the Samsung Developer Conference. So connect with us. So always become a Samsung Developer Program members. So there are a lot of benefits of joining the program, and you can always be in touch with us with technical questions or suggestions or feedback. So that's about it. Thank you for joining today's webinar. I hope it was useful. Always keep in touch with us through email. Thank you. Bye-bye.